Hey guys, it's Nicole. It's Wednesday, so it's hashtag Ask Nicole once again. And sadly, one of you viewers out there is experiencing some workplace bullying and you want some tips. The very first tip I would give anyone would be to make sure that you control your emotions. Nothing is worse than seeing somebody at work lose their mind. Whether it's crying or flailing or throwing things or using profanity or physically assaulting somebody, there isn't any type of phrase or sentence or person that could make me lose my mind at work. I need my money to pay my bills and to thrive in life. So do not give someone power over your emotional setting. If you have been bullied for a day or 14 years, cope with the situation until you are in the proper setting to release your emotions and explain yourself. But do not burst out and express yourself, because in the improper setting, showing your emotions makes you seem crazy. And I know where you're thinking, well, you know, it's not like that. I'm just upset. And, you know, this is how I express myself. And that's absolutely fine. But it has to be done in the proper setting. You bursting into tears and throwing things when I'm trying to give you a report seems a little bit crazy. And you seem a little bit unstable. So if you really want people to take you seriously as a professional, explain yourself in the proper setting, and by all means, please make sure you control your emotions, because we're all adults. My second tip, if you know the bullying is still continuing, even though you're trying to avoid it, so to speak, would be to talk to the bully. Sometimes it's all perspective based, and if you sit down and tell this person, I've been disrespected in the following ways, and here are some examples, and I really would like if you stop, and they accept what's going on. Sometimes they legitimately don't know what's happening and they stop. Sometimes, sadly, this doesn't work and they don't really care and it continues. But this is kind of the defining moment in bullying, because you'll know they really didn't mean to and there was a miscommunication in its entirety, or they really mean to bully you. They want to hurt your feelings and they don't respect you as a person, so you need to move on from there. After this defining point, you then might have to move to tip number three, which is talking to management, because sometimes you cannot get your point across until someone is spoken to by management. Do you want to get people in trouble? No, but you should not be afraid to go to work. Sometimes bullying is gender-based. Sometimes it's based on age. Sometimes it's based on experience. There are tons of reasons why humans are mean to other humans, but this is a medical professional environment. We are all expected to rise above, to be responsible, to be understanding of each other. And that doesn't mean that just because you have your CCRN that you're allowed to bully a GN. I have tons of certifications, but I don't go around bullying people, because that doesn't make you a better person in the end. So if you're experiencing bully out there, you know, control your emotions. You know, try to explain yourself to the bully in the proper setting, in a semi-private area, you know, that has, you know, people somewhat walking through, so that you aren't locked in a room with someone that could possibly beat you up. You know, keep it safe. And then the last tip is to talk to management if all else fails. But I wish you all out there the best of luck. To the viewer out there who's experiencing this, if you have any questions, please email me. You have my contact information, and that's really it, guys. As always, if you guys have any questions or comments for me, pop those below as well. Thanks for watching, guys. Have a happy, happy new year, and take care as always. Bye.